little girl and a little dog floating by my arms. Screaming, Auntie M, Auntie M. It was bad when I killed him.
We're going to call the November 6th Drainage Board meeting to order. Ms. Heather, let it be known that I think Adrian Thompson is working. He is absent. Mrs. Fontenot is going to lead us in a prayer, followed by the pledge.
Father God, as always, we come before your throne, giving you honor, giving you glory. Father, tonight, we want to bring to your attention that you might comfort the family of the Jeff Wiley and Joe Wiley family who've lost their mother this past week. We also want to thank you for the good news that I received yesterday that a friend of the council, Phil Garrett, has gotten his new lung and is doing well. So though we have sad times, Lord, we do rejoice for the good times also. We ask tonight that you bless us, that you give us the wisdom that we need to conduct this meeting in a proper manner and do the things that is necessary for the Parish of Ascension. As always, we pray for the safety and the quick coming home of our soldiers that are abroad, and we thank you for those that are here defending us today. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, liberty and justice for all.
We'll move on to the public comment section. Anybody wanting to speak on an agenda item, please sign in. Some sign-up cards at the desk. You have 3 minutes on an item. Number four, we're going to move on to additions. Two-thirds. Anyone have two-thirds?
Mr. Chairman, I have a two-thirds.
Okay, Mr. Denson.
Yeah, the two-thirds is Greenfield Crossing. We need some box culverts. Mr. Rue would have any additional comments on that?
Okay, I got a motion.
I'll second it.
Second by Ms. Fontenot to put it on the agenda. We'll put it at any objections? So moved. Thank you. Yes. Put it at 28.
I just got a
23. 28. 28. Sorry. There's an apple. Mr. Chairman, since Mr. Rubin's going
to be up here anyway for number
8, we maybe just put it under there and get it out of the way. That's fine. That way we dedicate all of 20 to the budget.
That's fine. Mr. McCall, any objection for that? We're going to move on to number 5, acceptance of minutes of October 2nd, 2006.
That's a move, Mr. Chairman.
Second.
Got a motion by Mr. McConnell, second by Mr. Valentine. Discussion? Any objections? So moved. Move on to number 6, Parish President's Report. Mr. President.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Good evening, everyone. I must say it's been some interesting reading of lately, talking about major drainage in the parish. And you know, it's good to serve in public office and to have fun at the same time while you're doing it. And most of the report tonight as far as major drainage will be given by our public works director. Particularly notice that for the dredging that's been going on Black Bar, we've made significant progress, and Bill going to give us details on that. But we're now between Highway 44 and Germany Road as we go up to the upper reaches of that as far as clearing and all. We've made available to you, as you consider what you want to do with your drainage situation, the finance office as well as the public works office. And so Mr. Rue and Mr. LeBlanc are still available as you need them with questions you may have. As you get into this more, you're going to see some of the challenges that you'll be facing and whatever decision you make. And finally, we just want to remind all of you, tomorrow is National Election Day, and so we all have busy schedules, but want to recognize that it's on a weekday, and so it's our citizens go out and vote. That's an important part of the process, freedoms that we enjoy here. So just a reminder to all of you as well as the rest of our citizens about the election day tomorrow. So thank you, Mr. Chairman.
Yeah, Mr. Hillensbeck.
Yeah, thank you, Mr. Chairman. Just one comment in response to the President's remarks about Black Bayou. We are not dredging Black Bayou. What we're doing is maintenance work, and that is cleaning, cutting, shaping, sloping the sides, squaring the bottom. Am I correct, Mr. Root?
That's correct.
Okay, just want to make sure that the public's not misinformed, that they think we're doing one thing and we're actually doing something else. I'm glad what we are doing is taking place and it is helping Black Bayou, but it's not dredging, and we canceled the dredging program. So I just want to state that for the record. Thank you.
No questions? Move on to number 7, ad hoc committee for a drainage administrator, Mr. McConnell.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Yes, sir, the ad hoc committee that was tasked by this drainage board to consider a drainage manager for the parish and look at everything. We've met a couple of times on it. We met about 2 weeks ago. For the last meeting, I did invite all of the drainage board members, asked that they attend out of respect to them to give input, specifically requested Mr. Savoy because he is also the council chairman to attend. And we had a good attendance. We had a good debate and a good discussion. And I guess it's the worst-kept secret in the parish, so I'll just announce that the recommendation of that committee was, since the parish president intends to void his contract or not renew his contract on January 1, under the given circumstances and the drainage, the committee was not willing to change those circumstances, then it was the recommendation of the ad hoc committee that this drainage board proceed with the hiring of a drainage manager effective January 1, 2007. And further, it was the recommendation of this ad hoc committee that we contract with URS, who is our parish consulting engineer, independent consulting engineer, to help the drainage board to develop a job description and all of the necessary requirements to put this drainage manager in place and this drainage department in place. And that was a recommendation of the committee, sir.
So moved, Mr. Chairman.
And a motion by Mr. Barger.
Second.
Second by Mr. Valentine. Discussion?
Discussion.
Mr. Hillensbeck.
I guess the question I have for Mr. Hughes is, Mr. Hughes, you do not intend to allow your contract to be renewed in January. Is that the case, or?
I don't remember saying that, but, I mean, the contract is not a renewable contract. It was set into, I think, forever, back in January of 1994, if I remember. So it's not a – it's a contract that was signed until, I think, either of three parties, as I recall, Doug. I'd have to go back and look at it. O'Neill may know. But it was actually the parish council, first parish president, and the East Ascension Consolidated Drainage Board, and a separate one with the West Ascension Consolidated Drainage Board.
All right. Well, that was new
so
to me.
I understand it, it does not expire at a certain date. It was just in effect until those three parties did something otherwise.
Yeah, I appreciate that because I'd never heard you say either that you intended to void the contract or let it expire or whatever. So
there is no expiration date in it, as I understand it.
Okay, thank you.
That's a balance down.
Just a point of comment. Past president did say that this drainage board had to change its ways, give him complete control, and if we didn't, he did mention the fact that come January 1, he would have to consider giving it up, and that's why we ended up doing what we're doing. We actually have two separate agreements, one with East Ascension Gravity Drainage District, and then he also has a separate agreement with the West Ascension Drainage District, and they will have to act on that as they see fit. This is concerning the East Ascension tonight, and that's what we're discussing. And so, it was already the line was drawn in the sand as some things have been said. There's some things that's been said in the paper about having fun with this. He may mention it again tonight. I don't see anything funny about it or fun with drainage. Drainage is a serious problem, and we need an administrator that's going to be serious about it. It's going to give us some leadership qualities and some direction on what we should do. We're the legislative body. All we do is legislate. We don't actively tell or direct the people in the field. This board seemed fit to get an ad hoc committee. They went through the process. This is a recommendation.
Mr. McConnell.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. I expressed my views. I was chairman of the ad hoc committee, and I thank the members for that honor and that vote of confidence. However, I was the one member of the committee who disagreed with that particular vote, and my reason being is I believe the drainage board and drainage in this parish would be a lot more effective if we continue having the parish administrator, the Ascension Parish president, administer that that contract the way we have it going. Also, there's the fact that besides just the actual drainage work that's going on, the parish administers the money, the parish administers the personnel, the parish administers the payroll and the benefits and all of that. Plus, over the years, all this money has been commingled. There are lots of pieces of equipment out there that that the drainage board might own two-thirds of and the parish might own one-third of. And I'm talking out of the top of my head. I can't tell you that for fact. And if you ask me for specifics, I couldn't give you any. But I know that even the Public Works building that we own, a portion of it was paid for by drainage funds and a portion of it was paid for by general funds. And my feeling was my reason for opposing the vote of the ad hoc committee was that I felt like we got a better bang for our buck with what we were doing the way it is, and I'm just afraid that administration cost, because we're gonna have to contract now with the parish to administer these funds unless we want to hire our own administrator to do all of that stuff for us. We're going to have finances in place. We're going to have all of that in place. Now suddenly we'll be like a fire department paying somebody to administer that for us instead of the administration doing it automatically. So I just feel like we're creating an additional bureaucracy or an additional cost, and we'll be allocating costs to administration of these funds that are already being administered. And I think we just I think this drainage board and this parish would be better served to maintain the status quo and have the administration to continue the administration. But that was my reasons for opposing that. Now, whatever this drainage board decides to do, I feel like we need to go out and make the best of it and do what's best, because, as I keep repeatedly saying, drainage is the most important. In my opinion, it is the most important thing. People gripe about roads, or they gripe about the regulations, or they gripe about building permits, or they gripe about growth, or they want to build a bridge, a brick wall at Bayou Man Shack, whatever they want to do. But drainage is the most important thing in this parish, and I don't want to do anything to jeopardize that. And I'm just afraid by splitting this up that it would. That's my concern, and that's why I oppose that vote of the ad hoc committee. Thank you.
But I might say a couple of things, then I'll get back to you, Dan. I agree with you, Martin, on some things, but you said leave it like it is. That's what we were intended to, because I thought the drainage department was doing a great job. We do more work projects that help more people than any other department that's out there. But they've come up about where Mr. President wants to make a change on it in the Home Rule Charter, the way the Home Rule Charter. We would have to change the Home Rule Charter to change what he's wanting to do. That's changing. We was going to leave it just like it was, but that didn't come from us.
We'd have to change state law,
right,
to do all of that, because this drainage board was created by an act of the Louisiana legislature.
So that's what I'm saying is, you know, a lot of things are going to have to be done to go. It's not going the same route we were going. It would be a change anyway. Or he gave us the ultimatum that he was going to resign as administrator. So that's why, you know, the ad hoc committee got together and started looking, and that's where we are today. But, yeah, I agree. It was doing great. I don't understand why we needed a change. But apparently administration thought we needed a change, and that's where we're at. Mr. Hillensbeck.
Yeah, thank you, Mr. Chairman. You're right. If for this drainage board to be done away with, it'd take an act of the legislature. And I can tell you, as far as our legislative delegation, they're not going to support that unless all of us, as councilmen, including the parish president, are all on board with this move, and we see that this is the direction that we think the parish needs to take. Then you might get some legislation sponsored, and then you might be able to get it out of committee, get it to a vote. But as it stands right now, we've got differing opinions on whether or not we should be under the Home Rule Charter or whether we should continue on like we're doing now. My concern is what would be the cost of this major of undertaking? And Mr. Hughes, if I may, could I ask Ms. LeBlanc, Chief Financial Officer, to come to the microphone? I just got a couple of questions.
Mr. Chairman.
Sure, Mr. President.
Gwen, are you prepared to
answer
questions? Or?
Hey, just what I asked you the other night, Gwen, prior to the council meeting, I asked Ms. LeBlanc. Ms. LeBlanc is the Chief Financial Officer and the Treasurer for the parish. I said, Ms. LeBlanc, this move that's being contemplated here that we might be going to, what is this going to cost the parish? And of course, she's pulling the numbers off the top of her head and also what she's heard, but didn't you tell me, and you got your figures from Mr. Rue, if we were to separate these bodies and hire our own outside administrator, this could cost the parish $1.2 million a year to help fund this. Am I correct?
Right. It would if you totally separate and don't contract back with the parish, and that's based on figures that Bill Rue has given me, and those are estimated figures on employees.
Yeah, okay, $1.2 million. That's annually. That's not a one-time cost. That's annually. It comes out of the parish to help fund this endeavor if we decide to go down this road. Now the next comment I have is I apologize, I haven't made all the meetings, but I understand we've got someone working on a job description and a figure of $85,000 a year was thrown out. We were going to pay this individual to be the drainage board administrator. Well, I don't think the public and the voters and taxpayers are going to support the idea. We're paying an individual now, Mr. Bill Rue, $67,000 a year to be both the DPW director and to administer the drainage board through our actions and under the wishes of the parish president. We're paying him $67,000 a year to do both jobs, and then we're going to turn around. We're going to pay one person, if I have my information right, $85,000 a year. That doesn't add up. I've heard of fuzzy math and bad math, but that's certainly, I think, the taxpayers would question that, and if we were to continue down that road. So I think there's some things we need to think about here before we go full out to hire an outside administrator, and we need to think about the problems it creates and what it actually costs the taxpayers of this parish, because I think what we're doing is we're creating more bureaucracy, which I don't think that's what the taxpayers want. And I'm not sure that we'll be any more efficient. I think there's going to be some problems if we go forward with this action. Thank you.
Mr. Breiser.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Mr. Rue, if you don't mind asking a couple of questions. It may mention that you said it would cost the parish $1.2 million. Is that the parish or the drainage board?
It's
could you explain? Excuse me, Mr. Hillsbeck, I got it right now. Thank you. I didn't interrupt you.
Of course, we're still putting figures together right now. The total separation for us employees, you're probably looking at the parish having to absorb probably in the neighborhood of $600,000 employee costs, road and bridge. The drainage department, the regular drainage, you're probably looking at having to absorb about $400,000 in employee costs. The drainage board, because of the way that the percentages worked out, probably looking at the budget coming down, probably $1.5 million. We're constantly looking at the figures, so we had the $1.2 million, but actually you're looking at about 1.5 major drainage funds saving on employee costs.
Saving.
Drainage. Drainage. That proves what we've always said, is we're robbing and pilfering the drainage fund to support parish government.
not exactly. The way we're working is using both, all the employees to do both work. We're using drainage employees to do road work when necessary. We're using road employees to do drainage work when necessary, especially weed control and in emergency situations such as hurricanes and storms and things like this. Based on the yearly average, our estimation was, and again, we're different for different types of employees, but weed control, we normally was putting about 30% of that weed control duties was off-road, 70% for the drainage department. So that it gave it a 70-30 split, so 30% of their salary being paid and equipment costs being paid by major drainage, because we estimated throughout the year they would be used off-road about 30% of the time.
Right. And we talked about fuzzy math. The numbers you just gave, you said a cost of $600,000 to the parish, an additional cost of $400,000 to drainage for employment, but also a savings of $1.5 million. So I see a net for drainage at about $1.1 million.
And again, this is numbers that
works out to be.
Right, and in credit to Mr. LeBlanc, this is numbers that really evolve in daily. We're working on it daily.
Right, I understand.
These are numbers I came up with today.
Just broad numbers that we're throwing out. We got a net of 1.1.
That may change some, yeah. But it's definitely a salary change decrease in a major drainage as it stands right now with the same number of employees.
But is that not correct? A net towards drainage, a savings of about $1.1 million?
That's right, but now you got to understand too that we were using some of the road people again. 30% of the time, we estimated as employees of off-road work. So to keep up, theoretically, to keep up the same amount of work off-road, we need to add more employees because again, we're using some of this off-road on-road off-road. So we may need to add more employees to pick up the slack.
Not $1.1 million worth.
Well, it
correct?
Depends on how many you want to add, yeah. And how much more work you want to do. So we're not completely finished.
The fuzzy math shows, guys, right now, if it's as is, we're going to save $1.1 million. Keep in mind, we're not wearing councilman hats now. We're taking care of drainage board tonight, which is a net savings of $1.1 million. So just be aware of that.
And Mr. Bill, mm-hmm. while we're on this subject, in the budget for 07 anyway, we are planning on hiring several crews in major drainage up. That's on the budget right now.
We did not. We looked at
it's
hiring
supposed to
a
be
few,
in the budget for about three crews.
Right, a few more, but not a lot.
The reason
as
why,
it stands right now.
Reason why we have been cut from like somewhere around 35 people in major drainage from this administration starting to now we're at 23. So our work orders are getting further and further behind. It's not because of what we have in the field. We have some super guys in the field, guys that does excellent work. Alan Allred, I want to commend him. He does excellent jobs, keeps his crews going with what he has. We need to help him out on that issue, and I thought we was going to amend the budget to fill these crews to where our capacity was when we come on board.
I can comment on that right now. Of course, it goes somewhat into the later agenda item on the budget, which I'm sure we're going to talk more about in detail. But one of the things is the fact that a lot of this decision on how we're going to prioritize projects and how we're going to change the way in other words, add zones instead of going parish-wide on work orders, we were going to come back with an amended budget to show the separation of employees and also to, because we're going through zones now for work orders and trying to remain in a zone, and we were going to add employees at that time. So in a budget that's being presented, it's not shown there, but we were going to come back with an amended budget to reflect all the changes at a later time.
Mr. President, can I ask Ms. Nguyen something? Yeah, Ms. LeBlanc, right now as we speak, we are paying 4% to the parish from the drainage across the top for administration.
How much is that?
Let's see. I gave that figure to the committee. It was. It was $457,000 from, and that's from.
And we're paying that right now.
From the entire drainage district.
Okay.
and we're paying that now, and then there was an extra $160,000 for maintenance.
What does this consist of? What does this pay, should I say, out of this 4%?
Okay, this is in accordance with Act 138 of the Louisiana Legislature that allows all parish governments, if their general fund, and general funds are required by law, every government has a general fund, and that is to provide any authorized legal services provided by government, including drainage. You could spend it on drainage also. But in return for that, if you are administering funds for all other departments, like we have some 50-some-odd funds, that's like 50 different companies, then we can charge up to 4% of their revenues each year to administer that. And that would be all the administration charges, you know, that Ronnie is giving President Hughes, DPW, what his salaries are already being just, you know, charged directly. But finance, ISGIS department, the health department, I mean the legal department, our purchasing department, you know, all those services that are provided to all the funds.
And we're paying that now.
And that's what you would be paying for, including the share of your audit, you know, and to film this meeting tonight, things like that. All the software that we have that's in a network system. Legal services.
Thank you. Thank you, Mr. LeBlanc. Mr. Shakespeare.
Yes, and just on that subject, and my question is, what would change? It's very simple. If we continue to pay the 4%, nothing would change there. I think we need to back up. This is something, again, that I appreciate. Parish President for bringing up some questions early in the year and everything got me and many others thinking about the Drainage Board. The Drainage Board was started by a state legislative law, and we are mandated by that state law to administer this Drainage Board. This is what we do. We were done by state law. We have an obligation on Monday, first Monday of the month, to meet for the Drainage Board, and that is our primary function. On two-thirds of the month, we meet as councilmen there, and, of course, in between. I think what has happened is that over time, from the very beginning, Parish President's administration has utilized the drainage boards into things that, as they said, commingled monies as best use as they could. And what ended up happening, the parish has gotten into a situation where nobody really knows where the money is going to or exactly. I mean, we're just in a situation where it has been commingled, it has been changed, it has been done this and done that. And the initial idea of a drainage board to administer drainage in this parish has been muddled and kind of stuck in a bureaucracy from the standpoint of how do we find out exactly how much drainage board money is spent on drainage. We don't know. As Mr. Rue said, some of the crew is 70-30. Finance is being paid X amount. Personnel is being paid X amount. All of this is being done. I think, you know, this is not rocket science. $6-8 million budget. We're eliminating a bureaucracy, and we're putting all the monies in an organization that's going to be accountable for the monies. The drainage board, who is accountable for all the monies in drainage on the East Ascension side, will then be accountable to hire an administrator who will be responsible to the drainage board. Very simple. The school board does it. They hire a superintendent. They administer that. He works 24 hours a day for the school system. I've said it before. I think Mr. Hillenbeck said it eloquently. We have a DPW director that's doing drainage. He's doing DPW. He's doing planning. He's doing other things. And quite frankly, we're not getting 24 hours, 7 days a week, work on drainage in this parish, which is what this state law was intended, is to administer drainage in this parish. There's no way you can do it when you're doing everything else. I think we need, I was very much like Mr. McConnell, drainage is the most important thing that we have to do in this parish. We cannot leave any stone unturned. The parish president has asked us many times in these meetings, what has been done with this money? I don't think there's anything that's been done with the Drainage Board with the money. We meet every time something comes up. We vote on whether to spend money or not. The administration of it or division of monies is done through the budget. We really don't know exactly how that day-to-day administration goes. So it's going to give us a chance, everybody, a chance to step back, go back to what the Drainage Board was intended to be, what it started out to be. Let everybody catch our breath. Put the Drainage Board out there to do drainage in East Ascension Parish and work on that 100%. I do believe, as Mr. Barriga said, that the net savings to the Drainage Board is going to be substantial, that you're going to see some money being opened up to actually do drainage projects that are now caught up in bureaucracy through nobody's fault. It's just evolved over time, and it is something that has happened, and I think that as you shrink this down and you focus in one area, that you can better utilize our monies. And that's the only area Mr. McConnell and I differ, is that I think we can better utilize our monies this way, and he feels like we can better utilize our money the other way. And we had talked about using workers for drainage in other areas like road and bridge and things like that. Well, we still pay them out of drainage money. We pay them a percentage. So I think what we're going to see is that we're going to cut down some overhead. We're going to utilize already our workers that we have now. We're going to be able to free up some monies to hire more workers or to take whatever extra monies and be able to contract some services out to get more work done. And that we're going to be a more efficient group of people in the Drainage Board. And as I've said, I just think it's time to step back, take a look at it, and start over from that position, and I think we're going to see some positive things. And I would like to move on that, and we'll see how it works out. I think this time next year we'll get a lot better idea from that point. But I just think it's something that evolved over time, and things can start over and do a better job.
Just one last question from Ms. LeBlanc. Gwen, I hate to call you back up to the mic, but I didn't misunderstand you the other night when we discussed this. I think the number you gave me was a cost to the parish if we go forward with this of $1.2 million annually. And you said, these are the numbers. I'm getting these numbers from DPW and Bill Root, and that's what it looks like it's going to cost if we go forward with this. Correct?
Right. Well, the figures I got from Bill Root plus the cost that the 4% that the Drainage Board now pays the parish government combined.
On top, okay.
You said those were preliminary figures and they were still being worked up by Bill Root. He was going to meet with me. We haven't met yet.
Yeah.
To give me those estimates or projections. Right. And also that if the Drainage Board continued to contract with the parish, then it would be minus, $600,000.
Right. Okay, thank you. I certainly don't mean to put you on the spot, but I want to make sure we can put the information out there. Thank you.
Okay.
Mr. Sexton? Gwen, before you go, you said it would be lost to the parish of $1.2 million. Where would that money go?
Well, it would go
back. The money's still there. Where would it go?
To drainage.
It would remain. Go back to drainage.
It would remain in drainage, I would
okay,
say.
And that's our point, is that we have $1.2 million is now spent.
But it would. If you do not contract with us, it would cost you a lot to
exactly,
provide the services.
And the question is whether it's going to cost less or not.
Right.
But we have to, we are mandated to look for, in this particular night, we're here to look for the best interest of drainage, major drainage. And exactly what you're saying is that by this change, we're going to move $1.2 million from overall parish government to back to major drainage, where it legislatively should be. Then what major drainage does with it is up to major drainage from there. So that's
right. And we discussed this at the ad hoc committee meeting, but it was my understanding from the committee that your first choice was to remain with a contract with the parish. Did I get?
Well, they would, all of those things are up for discussion.
Right.
Mr. Byer.
Yeah, thank you, Mr. Chairman. Just a little bit more, since we got a little bit more on our math figures, we was 1.1, and if it cost the drainage board, which I don't think it will cost, if it cost us the whole $600,000 to administer it, we still got a net of $500,000. So as far as I'm concerned, no matter what way we turn, we're going to save, no doubt, at least a half a million dollars if it costs the whole $600,000 to administer it, which I really believe we can do it a little cheaper than that. So we still have a net savings.
This is fine.
I was part of the ad hoc committee and member, and I take drainage seriously in Ascension Parish, and I've said on many occasions that it is number one. I was one of them that tried to offer a compromise at the first ad hoc meeting we had and was told that that really wasn't an option. And at the second meeting, came back still even thinking that we could have a compromise, that there was some kind of way that we could work this out. And it came down, especially, you know, when we expected the parish president to come to our meeting, and he didn't come because he was advised not to. It made it difficult to even try to work out a compromise because he wasn't there to work out a compromise with. So we made a decision. We had to make a decision, and we made a decision. I think at this time that we need to look for a new beginning. Obviously, this has not worked out through three administrations. It has not worked out. We're getting blamed meeting after meeting about $100 million being spent. We've only been here 3 years, so we couldn't be responsible for any of that. We have no day-to-day control over what goes on in drainage as far as to say how many crews we need or things like that. And so I just think it's time, and I will stay with my position that it is time to move on and see what we can do to make sure that Ascension Parish that pays the tax for drainage gets the best drainage department that they can possibly have. So that's my feelings on this matter. Thank you.
Any more questions? Mr. President.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Good to listen to all your comments. And let me first say that I respectfully disagree with some of your comments. And I think you can have fun as a public servant without making fun of issues, Mr. Valentine. I hope you enjoy. You know, life is fun. Public service can be fun, especially when you work together. So if you misunderstood that, well, then so be it. The opportunity to serve is obviously an honor and fun. And we can debate, you know, what's more important. You know, is it roads, is it drainage? I just remind you, the last time I checked statistics, we had never had a person die in Ascension Parish in a flood or drainage event. We've had a lot of people killed on our highways. And to me, the most important responsibility we have, be it on a drainage board, and by the way, there's very few states, and if you like that, we're hoping you look for best practices when you got into this process. Less than three parishes we found thus far have drainage boards anymore in the state. And if you want to know a little history of why we have one, you said some things that you may not be completely accurate. And if you go back 25 years, none of us probably know for sure, but from the best we can understand, talking to the people involved back then and the people on the Home Rule Charter Commission, people on the original drainage board, if you would, who are still alive, there were three police jurors on the West Bank that had a good bit of political power. And they would get with three of the ones on the East Bank, three of the eight, and they would do things by forming a coalition, those six, and control things. And so therefore, they went to Representative Russo and Representative Diaz, some of the other five, to try to stop that. So I think it's important that you have it, your facts straight from a historical perspective on why these drainage boards were created. as special legislative acts. And then when we went and voted on our home rule in 1994, if you go back and study home rule, what it means is that people would like to separate themselves from the state and have home rule instead of the state dictating to us what we do in Ascension Parish. Now, that's still subject to the state constitution, revised statutes, common law, as well as special acts of the legislature. So, and I've read and purposely stayed away from Yanhack meetings, and I've been reading the minutes. Everything each one of you have said in these meetings, and I have not found yet one person that's gone to different parishes, to different states, looking for best practices. Who's doing it right? Who's doing it wrong? And I found one parish in our state that still, they have one elected official on the drainage board, but that person was on the drainage board before they got elected to the parish council. And if you go back to your August meeting, it wasn't an ultimatum that the parish president gave you. It was some complaints that you gave. And I tell you that, and if you're going to, we're going to have to really revise the budget, Mr. Shakespeare, if we're going to have someone working 7 days a week, 24 hours a day on budget, on drainage, major drainage, to get those kind of crews out there. It's going to take significant more money than what we've been spending on major drainage. Now, in addition, you may want to look at the AG opinions they gave a while back, and the district attorney's office disagrees with it a little bit. That's going to be an interesting situation. But the attorney general actually said that the parish council is the governing authority of Ascension Parish through the powers of the Home Rule Charter, has authority over drainage as it is now. And I submit to you that the people voted for the Home Rule Charter because they wanted to have Home Rule. And just as they expect us to, two branches of government with checks and balances, they expect us to take care of roads and drainage and recreation and health units and other things. Most of our citizens expect that in all areas of parish government and local government. So I think it's a little short-sighted of us to say that drainage is the most important issue, or this is the most important. There's a lot of important issues in our parish, but certainly the life of our fellow citizens is the most important. And I encourage you to look at what others are doing, to look for best practices as you go through this process of trying to find a common ground that you feel good about. But keep in mind the political circumstances of why these two drainage districts were formed in about 1984. And I think if you go back and find out with the attorney at the time and the makeup of the police jury, you'll find that. And with a lot of politics in that, not just necessarily best practices for good drainage. Now, I've read in the paper and heard Mr. Valentine just say that parish president wanted complete control. Undoubtedly, some of you didn't listen in September or you didn't read. I never said that. Nor did I issue an ultimatum, as Councilman Ty Lambert said. I gave you three examples of things that we had found that might work in our parish. One of which was to put drainage, as our charter talks about, under the charter like we do with pretty much everything else. Now, that's not complete control. That's the power and control of the Home Rule Charter that our citizens voted on in 1984. Where you have checks and balances in that charter, 22 branches of government. When one branch thinks the other branch is mistaken, well, it can be corrected. So that was what, now, if that's complete control, I don't think so, because certainly the parish president in our Home Rule Charter does not have complete control. It's very well spelled out, the powers of the executive branch and the powers of the legislative branch in that charter. Now, we're here as an administration to work with you to find what will work best for the citizens of our parish so we can have the very best major drainage. Just the last few weeks, if you put in interest on investments, the 1/2 cent sales tax has generated close to about $113 million since inception. In no time have we tried to imply that people stole that money or robbed and thieved, like Councilman Barger said. Now, has some of it been wasted? Probably by all of us. Probably by those who preceded us, who spent it where it shouldn't have been spent. probably no doubt about it. If you want to come by my office, I can give you a stack of legal opinions this thick from the district attorney's office and from the attorney general on opinions. If you talk to the original members who were involved in this back when we went to our charter, they would tell you two things, that they knew we would have problems with going forward, and some of you said that's certainly been a problem now for three administrations. Number one was drainage, and number two was the size of the council, 11 council members, and drainage not being part of the council. You go back and talk to the chairman of the charter commission, they will tell you those things. That was two issues that they figured would be problems as we went forward. If you go back and check on the parishes that went to homeroom charters along the Mississippi River and in Terrebonne and other places where you have some serious drainage issues, you'll find that almost all of them did away with their drainage boards, even though they had been formed by special legislative acts, and they put it under their charter so the government could be administered by both branches of government. Where you have checks and balances and accountability built into the system that our founding fathers envisioned many years ago. Now, you'll also find, for example, in St. Charles, they kept the taxing district in place for revenue purposes, but they transferred the special legislative powers of that act with that taxing drainage district to the council and to the parish president when they went to their homeroom charter in 1980. They've avoided many of the problems that this council, administrations, and drainage boards have had since 1994 when we went to our charter. You'll also find the same thing basically in St. James, Iberville, East Baton Rouge, Terrebonne, Lafourche, St. Tammany has drainage districts. However, that's the parish where they have one elected official only on the drainage board, and that's the person that was on the drainage board before they were elected to the council. And the attorney general has given an opinion that that does not constitute dual office holding. Now, and so I just encourage you to really, don't just stop at the first step. Really get into this if you're looking for the best drainage plan for the parish and you're truly looking for best practices. Don't limit yourself in your scope and your mission. And the administration will work with you for what's best for the citizens of our parish. And if you have questions, my staff's available to help answer them for you. But when I hear misinformation or misstatements, it's my responsibility to correct some of those, I think. We just received one of the best financial audits I think the parish has ever received. And Councilman Shakespeare and I said, no one knows. Well, we do know. It's spelled out very clearly. Now, there's certainly some questions. When you have a bad weather day, for example, and you got people that maybe they can't go do drainage, but they can go do something else on the side of the road, on how you allocate the time and the resources and how much of this track is owned by major drainage and how much is owned by parish government, I think the thing that I would like to ask us all to really focus on is that it's owned by the people of Ascension. They pay the taxes. Regardless if they pay it to a drainage district or they pay it to parish government, that's what they focus on. I don't think the average citizen cares who owns the Traco or who owns the building on Church Point Road. They care how their money is spent and how does this drainage board or this council and this administration account for that money and those resources. And I guess it would be difficult to go back to 1984 and try to find out how many square feet in this building is owned by drainage board and how much this building is owned by. I guess we could certainly do it, though. I'm sure we can because the financial office keeps very good records and audits have been done every year. But it certainly does make it more taxing to try to keep up. So, and the only parish that I can see that completely separates us is Livingston, as I told you back in the September response to your August attacks, was that they had three drainage districts. They were completely separate from the parish governing authority and the parish president. They had no elected officials serving on those three drainage boards. And they had their own equipment, their own people, according to their parish president. That's one of the models I offered to you as a path forward that you may want to consider. And that's the only one we've found thus far that does it that way, but even them, they do not have elected officials on their drainage board. And I guess the question I'll end with and the comments on this, and again, I want to emphasize that we're going to work with you any way we can. If we do need a drainage board and the trends in our state are away from those, but let's just say for the sake of discussion, we agree we need one. Why would you have the same people who already have governing authority and powers under both of the police powers of the state constitution as well as our home rule charter make up the drainage board? Talk about a redundancy or another bureaucracy where you already have those powers as a member of the governing authority. And so, you know, this issue can become political. We can try to blame people. We can try to do a lot of things. I just ask that you really look at what are the best practices, what will work for Ascension Parish, what is the right thing for Ascension Parish. And just maybe if everybody else has moved away from this kind of a system or model, why do you think they did that? Okay, you know, what was their reasoning for doing something different? And I think that's why we're all elected to public service. Most of us, you guys were probably kind of like me when we applied for the job of parish president, didn't realize I was applying for a separate job as a parish drainage board administrator. I think most of our citizens just thought we did it all, you know, in the parish government. They probably didn't realize you were applying for a separate job to be a member of a drainage board separate from being the governing authority, and that's just the citizens I talked to. I mean, we just don't think that way. Kind of like thinking about I'm on a parish road or a state road when I'm stuck in traffic, or if my child or close friend gets killed in an automobile accident. We really don't care if it's a parish road, a state road, or a federal road. We just want the roads to be safe. And I think that's the way most people feel about drainage. They just want the very best drainage plan that we can have with the resources and money we have available. And it is very simple. You just have a major plan and you implement it, and you're going to have to revise it every now and then as the parish changes, those demographics change. And if the plan that was approved by the voters in 1984 had been completed, at least some semblance of a time period that was recommended in that plan, we probably wouldn't even be having these discussions tonight. But most of these problems would have been resolved with that major drainage plan that our voters approved in 1984. So I end with that, Mr. Lambert, and I appreciate the opportunity to make some comments here. I've been listening to everyone talk about these issues. And
thank you. Any more discussion? Yes, sir. Mr. Sideboy.
I'm sure I won't be as lengthy as the parish president. I do have some very concerning comments. One is on the September meeting where the parish president came to the drainage board with a page and a half discussion. I recall, I don't want to say an ultimatum, but I do recall that he said that he would not sign the agreement in January. I don't think I'm wrong on trying to remember that. I think that's what he said. I did call today administration to try to get a copy of that document. I asked back in September for a copy of that document, and I did receive it. It is at my house, but unfortunately, I'm still on a turnaround, and I'm not spending much time at home. So I did call administration today so I could have that to review, to recall what exactly was said at the meeting. But my best recollection is that it was mentioned that he would not renew the contract in January. Now, tonight, he's stating that the contract really doesn't expire. It just goes on and on. And that's true. But he did mention that he would not sign it. Now, the only thing I could come up with real quick was the copy of the Gonzales Weekly of October 27th, and I'll read one paragraph. Hughes had advised the Drainage Board that if it did not permit him to fully manage drainage issues, he planned to stop being administrator for the board in January. So that kind of reinforces my thought of what he said in September. But I didn't get that copy today to verify that. Now, Mr. McConnell, I'm going to take what the comments that you said at that heart, because I feel a lot of how you feel. I really do. I would love for the board to continue operating under parish government administration. What I can recall, and the reason that we're where we're at, from what I remember, is we discussed this drainage board, this special drainage district, talked about bringing on a manager to oversee major drainage, because we felt with the amount of jobs that's out there, the amount of money that's coming in, that we needed someone to pay a little closer attention to major drainage. That was our thought. Now, that discussion has brought us to the point where parish president says, I'm going to cut ties in January if I don't get veto power, if I don't get and he mentioned something about the board, needing to do away with the board, if I recall. There's two things that we do not have control over. It's going to take a vote of the people of Ascension Parish to change the charter, and it's going to take a vote of the legislature. So what he's requesting, we can't do individually. Okay? Now, let's go back to February 20th at the State of the Parish address. The parish president did mention back in February the same thought, that he thinks that we should have major drainage fall under the umbrella of parish government. That's fine. But from February to November, what has he done? Had a great opportunity to lobby, to put together a piece of legislation to show us to move forward to trying to do that. That hasn't been done. So far as a choice, I would really like to stay as we are, with the exception of bringing on a manager. Because I personally believe we need one at this point in time. But I'm going to go back from what I remember was told to us in September. He needs veto power. He wants to do away with the board. And he wants full control. Well, he's got somewhat. Well, I'm sorry. Scratch control. Okay. Now, in talking with members of the board, I don't know of anyone that's willing to support at this time doing away with the board. Okay? So we can't meet that requirement. Okay? So unless the parish president states here tonight that he's willing to continue being the administrator without veto power, without dissolving the board, and bringing on administrator, there's really not a choice for us, really. That's all I got, Mr. Chairman.
Thank you, Ms. Semmel. Mr. Berger. Mr. Chairman, I call a question on the motion. We're going to go ahead and move. We got a motion on the floor by Mr. Berger, second by Mr. Valentine. Discussion is finished. Any objections?
I object.
Three objections, Mr. McConnell, Mr. Hillensbeck, and Mr. Dempsey Lambert. Motion carries.
Mr. Chairman. I hate to tell you this, I'm not finished my report.
That's a long report.
Wait, did you just vote on the question? Or did you just vote on the motion?
Voted on the motion.
Okay. All right.
I thought we voted question at the end of the debate. That's what the question was at the end of the debate.
End of debate.
So the debate, now we've got to go back to the original motion.
Mr. Valentine.
Yeah, Mr. Hillensbeck, right. Mr. Berger made call question. We need to vote on his question.
Okay.
And then vote on original
that
motion.
That was the question. Okay, we voted on the question. Mr. McConnell, finish your report, and we're voting on the motion.
No, you need to. I'd like you to vote on the motion, please, okay. Sir. Because the rest of my report depends on that.
Now we'll move on to motion. Mr. Barger, first, second by Mr. Valentine. Any objections?
I object.
Same bunch. Mr. McConnell, Mr. Hillensbeck, Mr. Dempsey Lambert. So moved. Pass.
Now that the vote has gone the way that it has, sir, there's some information that I have that I will be forwarding to the ad hoc committee. And I'll also forward out a courtesy to the remainder of the Drainage Board, possible job descriptions, possible organization charts, possible information for this ad hoc group to consider. Because we did decide at the ad hoc committee that, assuming that this event took place, that the ad hoc committee would not end at that point. So we're going to move forward with the decision of this board, and we'll work on that information. But I will go ahead and I do have that information. I was reluctant to forward it until after the outcome of this meeting. But I'll forward that information to you and hopefully to research some additional information. And then I need to look at my calendar first, but try to call an ad hoc committee meeting before the next drainage board so that we've had time to consider it and make another report to you, okay?
And in that report, I guess, Mr. McConnell, an intergovernment agreement is, y'all looking at that also with the parish as far as
That's up to the Ascension Parish Council to decide. Hopefully y'all know one or two people on the Ascension Parish Council that you can talk to about doing an intergovernmental agreement with them. I just want to say, though, I've been in parish government about 7 years, and pretty much my entire political career, I have spent it trying to heal the divisions that have gone on in this parish, and I'm very sad to tell you that I just presided over a group that caused one of the biggest political divisions in this parish, and it makes me very sad, but I'm going to work with the will of this board, but it's just disappointing that we can't strike a compromise. Thank you.
Any more discussion? Mr. Shakespeare.
I have to say something now, and I'm sorry. I beg to differ with you, Mr. McConnell. At the two meetings that I attended at the ad hoc committee meeting, we were there. Yes, we were charged with looking into hiring an administrator. And we had invited the parish president and the administration to attend. First time Mr. Rule attended, and we asked him point blank if there was any room for compromise on this issue. And he said, quite frankly, no, there was not. And the parish president had declined to attend at the second meeting. You yourself said you invited the parish president. He said no, his political advisors advised him not to attend, and he did not attend. And that was the time to work on trying to mend fences, trying to get this together. That's what we were there for. We stated very early on, is there any room for bringing this together? And correct me if I'm wrong, Mr. McConnell, you said you've spoken with the parish president, and he emphatically said no. Am I right?
I don't want to answer.
Yes.
Are you speaking, or is this a debate?
I'm asking if that's what your statement was when you spoke with the parish president as to were there any compromises on this issue.
The position was the same.
Yes. And because his position remained the same, it gave us no choice. And I, like you, wish things could have worked out differently. I really did. But at that point, it gave us no choice but to move forward. Now, just make sure everybody knows that. We did not intend to come in and divide this thing. This is what ended up happening. And so, thank you very much.
I'm going to let you rebuttal, Mr. President.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. We're going to continue this discussion. Yeah, we did send Mr. Rue and Ms. LeBlanc to your meetings representing the administration, Kent. But to say you have no choice would be a very socialistic type of viewpoint on government. We all have choices. And I outlined three, and if you go back and read my report in September, you'll see I gave you three choices in that meeting, okay, or three different models that would be possibilities for us to look at. In addition, I said there were other models, and we have actually called all 64 parishes in Louisiana since then. To my knowledge, none of you have asked for that information. And as I read the minutes of your meeting, nor did I see any indication in there, Ms. Fontenot missing a compromise. I've never seen her send that to me. Mr. Salvar just mentioned in my State of the Parish address, which I think was February 20th of this year, which many of you decided not to attend, that what has been done. Well, the following March, Jerry, as council chairman, assigned the various aspects of that State of the Parish address, called a time for choosing the different parish committees. The administration is still waiting for a report back from the Committee on Drainage. Because he's correct. In that State of the Parish address, I've made some comments that we need to look at drainage and how we're administering it. And Mr. Shakespeare, you made those similar comments many times. So from that State of the Parish address, February 20th, then in March, Mr. Salvar's council chairman, to his credit, and I commended him at that time, he made assignments to various committees of the council to look at the different aspects of that State of the Parish address. To this day, I have not received a written response or an oral response from that committee that was looking at the drainage and the comments I made that day. I pointed out in that report that sometimes we have buildings and equipment that's partly owned by parish dollars, partly owned by drainage dollars, and we need to try to address this because if you recall, at the time we was consolidating some parish government to more effectively use our taxpayers' dollars, some of you brought up the matter, can planning and development go into the public works building on Church Point because maybe those monies that built that building were all drainage monies. And so we tried to look into that at that time, and it just shows you the convolution sometimes that happens in these situations. Because I can assure you, our citizens don't really care. If we can consolidate parish government and improve our effectiveness and our efficiency in the services we provide to them. So that was stated very clearly in February. And to this date, November the 6th, have not received a report back from this government authority on some of those ideas. And so, Mr. Salvar, I appreciate you asking me what have I done in this issue. I appreciate you giving the assignment so the legislative body could let us know how you felt about it. But I thought it was a proper protocol for us to wait for a response from the council because we made the administration position clear that night on February the 20th. And so, now this ad hoc committee became part of that 6 months later. That's fine, or 7 months later. Well, I want our citizens to understand and just remind each of you respectively that if you go back and look at that State of the Parish address and my comments on drainage and go back to the March meeting where your council chairman made assignments on the aspects of that speech, you would then see that each part of that was assigned to one of your committees. And to this date, no members of my staff have received your report back on our suggestions for improving drainage. Thank you very much, Mr. Chairman.
This is fine. And then we're going to close.
Well, I felt that I needed to address the part about the compromise. There were two meetings that you didn't attend that the compromise was offered or tried to make a compromise. But you keep talking about us not giving you things. I sent you a drainage ordinance that was highlighted in red. You asked for it from all of us for us to send our comments. I faxed it to you. I got word back that it couldn't be read, so I hand-delivered one. I'm still waiting for your reply.
Okay, we'll move on. Move on to number 8, Department of Public Works report. Mr. Bill Rue.
Okay, I'm going to try to get through this pretty quick. But I have to report because on some things that was asked at the last meeting, and to expand on some things from that last meeting. As the President says, we are moving on Black Bayou. We have already cleared a good distance, and now we're actually digging as of today, continuing that project. Manchac Plantation, for that last meeting, we had some sinkholes. We have repaired those sinkholes. They are complete. Manchac Plantation cul-de-sacs, three locations there, flooding problems, actually some houses flooding. We have a plan to do it to resolve that issue, and we are coordinating our activities with utility companies right now. Seven Oaks, waiting on a flagman. It's later on in the presentation, actually in the agenda, to hire a flagman. We're looking at that location, also a location on Highway 30 along the railroad tracks. We had a few issues we're trying to resolve in Seven Oaks. If you remember back, Subdivision Committee was over here and presented a resolution to the board, and that resolution had two problems that we saw. Number one was they were requiring DPW to go in and use their servitude as per the original plat drainage plan as of 1996 and to construct the identical or the recommended drainage ditch as per that plan. We suggested that we could do the work within the right-of-way of the railroad track in a present ditch. Once we got out there, we found that that was impossible to do that and meet the requirements of the board, which the board adopted that resolution, and that subdivision committee to dig the same size ditch, same capacity ditch. To do so, we have to clear everything in the right-of-way and put it through the right-of-way as originally designed. We started that project and found that we had some conflict with some of the residents in that subdivision, and we're working through those problems right now. Basically, we're going to come back to the board and request that we do not follow that resolution exactly, because in doing so, we have to clear everything, and they do not wish us to clear everything in the right of way right now. So, again, we're resolving those issues, and we should have them resolved by the time we get to Flagman, so we can go ahead there and finish that project. Bayou Grand, box cover started today. Installing the box cover is going to be about a month, about a four-week project, but that's to relieve the flooding or hopefully relieve some of the flooding situation. Bayou Grand, that project will start it today. Panama what, Conway what Canals. Sir?
What location would you say?
It's on Bayou Grand Road, Bayou Grand North, and that's, of course, as you know, we had some issues and some subdivision people came and presented some facts that that we looked at, and we thought that putting the box covers in would relieve that problem. We started that project.
Okay, good, thank you.
Panama Conway Canals, NRCS bids advertised October 28th, and to do in at November 28th. So end of this month, the bids for the grubbing and cleaning of Bayou Conway and Panama Canals should start probably the first of the year. And in that project, we're going to go to the whoever is low bidder and work out a separate deal to do more work while they're there to do additional work for us. Dutton Road, we had a scope of work to relieve the flooding at the corner of Dutton Road and Highway 73 and U.S. 61, and that was to go along the railroad tracks with a large ditch. We have, subsequent to that decision at the last meeting, through the help of Mr. Parrington, we talked to the owner, Mr. Dutton, and he is requesting, he's actually suggesting that he'll give us whatever land we need in the back part of his property instead of the front along the railroad tracks to put a ditch. And now we're looking at actually going from the Highway 73, where the cover comes under 73 at the dentist's office. I think he came and had problems at the dentist's office along 73. Actually go west from there, northwest, across some property to the back part of Mr. Dutton's property. He's willing to give us whatever we need. So we're working with the other property owners to resolve that issue, the flooding of the dentist's office and also the corner of 61 and 73. Pizant Ditch, we commonly call it Pizant Ditch in Sorrento, it is on the schedule. We have the cup sheets, we have everything surveyed, and it just got to work up the schedule for that project. Morty Burette Ditch should complete the negotiation with other property owners tomorrow on relocation of that ditch, so we're making on the property line from Abby James Road to the first curve at Mr. Edmondson's property.
and reserve some longstanding issues up right-of-way in that area so we can maintain in the future. Chipping, you requested I give you a schedule of our chipping operations. CJ is handing out a schedule right now. It'll take us through, just with this one machine, take us through May of next year. It really has to do with five or six major projects. Five projects, we include a few. Number five includes a few ditches at one location. Right now, presently on Heath Bayou, should be completed November 16th. Geist Road will start at the completion of Heath at around November 20th to December 28th. Henderson Bayou is at Galvez Farm Subdivision, a Keystone Subdivision, hopefully starting around January 3rd, should last until February 15th. Muddy Creek is the next location west of Highway 42, hopefully around the mid of February to March 30th. And then the outfalls of Bayou Conway across Brittany Street to US 61, beginning around April, completing around May. This is our tentative schedule. We're going to try to meet the dates on the schedule, speed them up as possible, but that's the way it is up until May of next year.
Mr. Rook.
Yes, sir.
Parker Bayou should be included with this.
Yeah, it's all one. Henderson Bayou, Galvez Farm, that includes the Parker Bayou area. Thank and that whole, I guess, why. Parker, Burat, Galvez Farms, and the Keystone, Muddy Creek, right around Keystone area, that whole area.
Mr. Hill is back.
Yeah, thank you, Mr. Chairman. Bill, when you say Muddy Creek, west of 42, can you be 42 runs east-west?
Well, east-west.
You're talking about south of 42?
South of 42, and, okay. And that's what Muddy Creek does. It goes south away, then it actually goes west, yeah. All the way up to 61 and across 61. To the railroad tracks at Seven Oaks.
So you're talking about that section south of 42,
south
going
of 42,
back toward Airline Highway,
right, and curving west, and go as far as we can,
okay,
and relieve some of the brush and debris in that area.
Good, thank you.
Permitting, we have continued to have good dialogue with the Corps of Engineering on permitting issues, both past and future, trying to work on the things that clear up the past. Problems we had in URS, Jim LeBlanc is working real well with us and the Corps, and we're resolving those issues and getting a good plan together for us future permitting project. Mitigation, we're actively looking at having a parish mitigation bank, that is either our own bank or at least purchasing a number of units from a bank so we can use when we need it at a future date. We have a couple locations, at least one good location that we're pursuing, and URS is helping us with that also. Wetland delineation, last meeting you gave us the permission to hire some consultants. We are tasking. We just got the contracts in, executed contracts. Now we're able to issue the task order. We're moving on at least four locations for delineation, which is Marty Burat Ditch, Muddy Creek, south of LA 42 and west, Henderson Bayou and Bayou North Sea. Those are the four primary areas for future permitting for enlarging, and we're moving forward with them. Not necessarily in that order, but that is some of our primary project for us, delineation, and then toward the permit process. Marvin Bro Pumping Station, we do have two gearboxes on the screens that's being rebuilt, and we have two 7.5 horsepower motors that operate our gates that are also being reworked. They're not a problem right now. They all can be override functions on it, so we can operate it. But while we have some getting into the out of hurricane season, we're going in and doing some major maintenance on some of this machinery. Also, Barry Smiley is working with Mr. Chauvin. He will help us with some safe house structures on both the pumping station at McElroy and also at Sorrento, safe houses for when we have major hurricanes, they have a place to stay. And also at the one at the pumping station, we're hoping to enclose the whole structure in such a way that we can still operate the machinery, go back and forth from one to the other, but still be protected. And we're looking at that ability. If you remember, at the Sorrento pumping station, we had a problem with suction pump, a tire getting stuck in it. We have Barry has installed grates at those suction locations where this won't happen again. It's protected now. BKI is still working on the evaluation of the capacity of the pumping station, and they're having some problems with the core model. And we agree with BKI. There are some problems with the core model of Ascension Parish, especially these major canals. And we're setting up a meeting between URS, BKI, the DPW, and the core to resolve this issue before they can go any further. If you remember back several meetings ago, we had a cooperative endeavor agreement with Renaissance Subdivision to provide some drainage improvements with Providence Point, with longstanding problems with flooding in Providence Point. They agreed to put up $30,000 to do some improvements. We finally got the final plans for what we will be able to do in that subdivision. And we're going to be working, getting started working on bid documents based on the final documents, engineering reports.
Do you have a total cost on what the improvements are
there,
going to be?
Right now we're not, because we just got the full set of final plans, and CJ is reviewing those final plans to see what the exact cost as per those plans.
Any idea or estimate?
Not at this time.
Yeah, are you going to come back to the
board? We definitely will come back to the board, and we'll have to come back to the board permission, authorization to advertise for bids anyway.
Okay, good. Thank
and we'll have a budget estimate at that time. Okay, DOTD, barn at LA 30. We're looking at, we had a longstanding problem along LA 30. We're looking at DOTD is going to remove their fence at their barn so we can relocate a ditch. Through the help of Mr. Shake Snyder and contacting the railroad officials, we're looking at hopefully upgrading the crossing at that location and several other locations in the parish under railroad tracks. Muir Road off of LA 621, we're removing the bridge. We're going to be replacing it with box covers. And at the same time, we're going to do some work, realignment of the Bert Allen ditch to improve the drainage in that area. So, Mr. Chairman, that's the day-to-day reports of activities. I believe you should have in hand, and feel free to ask some questions about it, and we'll try to answer it tonight or in the future.
Take. Mr. Shakespeare?
Bill, could you pass along? Mr. Touye on Touye Road had discussed a problem he had with some culverts there, and the water had gotten in his house from the hurricane and afterwards, and he had called me not long ago and said he continues to have a problem. The culvert that he thinks is a culprit has not been changed or upgraded. So could you just look into it?
We can look into it. I think at one time we did blow it out and do some grading in that area, but we'll look at the capacity.
But he almost got flooded again,
right.
And he said it's continuing to be a problem, so you just might want to revisit
that. We evaluated and upgraded.
Okay, thank you.
To what it needs to be.
Mr. Savoy.
Yeah, Bill.
Two-year road.
Bill, as far as Heath Bayou and shredding Heath Bayou, where are we on that right now?
Should be finished.
Is that all the way to Severio Canal?
How far are you going?
They're right there by that crawfish pond, almost to the bridge on San Martin Road.
Okay, and we're going all the way to Severio Canal?
Yeah.
Well, for any of us that hasn't seen the machine work, you really need to try to get opportunity to see that big monster work. It's a pretty good piece of equipment. Thank you. Doing a good job.
Bill, I just wanted to make sure that you keep me up to speed on everything going on in Seven Oaks, Providence Point, and Dutton Road.
Yes, ma'am.
So, I don't like getting a phone call, so if you can keep me up to speed on it ahead of time.
Yes, ma'am, in fact, we can meet over the next day or two, and I can explain some of the problems we've had and how we came about making some of these changes. So, you feel free to call me, and we'll set up a meeting to go through some of the issues.
I certainly will. I appreciate it. Thank you.
Mr. Denson.
Lambert.
Yeah. Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Yeah, Mr. Rue, I'd like to also, I know CDM's coming next month with some, the completion of the modeling of Innocent Bayou. I want to schedule a meeting with Keystone, too. I want to try to compile all the information, and let's look at this basin.
Yes, sir, and I have a meeting, of course, the main thing with Keystone and doing some work further north or west of Keystone, more toward Burat Ditch and Parker Bayou, is some delineation and some permitting issues with the Corps, and that's why we got our delineation consultant working on that to resolve the issue so we can move forward with Keystone.
Any more discussion? Questions for Mr. Miller? Just we'll move on to the two-thirds Greenfield Crossing, Mr. Miller.
Yes, sir. What we have here is Greenfield Crossing. We have two crossings. Right now they have two large, I think, 36-inch, 48 culverts, inch culverts at each location. They're causing a problem because the fact that they're double-barrel culverts. They're collecting trash and they're causing flooding in that area. Request to put box covers at each one of these crossings, and the total cost is $37,500 to replace the covers with box covers. So
second. Got a motion by Mr. Shakesnyder, second by Mr. Dempsey Lambert. Any discussion? Any objection? So moved. We'll move on to number 9, bulkhead repair, rolling casing. Task order to consult engineer for repair specifications required to bid the project. Mr. Bill Root?
Yes, sir. We went round and round about this, and we had some local construction, bulkhead construction people come and give us estimates, look at it, and they suggest that we really get a detailed design of it from an engineer to reconstruct this, tear down the old one, reconstruct it, or repair it. But they're not willing to come in and just offer quotes on just repairing it as is because of the liability. To do so, we need to bid this. We need to go to an engineer and have an engineer prepare an engineering report on how to repair it. And we asking the board to, we don't have any suggestions for engineer. It's up to the board who you would like to task this to.
Mr. Lambert?
Mr. Barger.
Mr. Bill, can you give us some more information? What is this project? Where is it at? What's the problem?
The casing, that's at the Henderson Bayou. It came to the board several times. We've been having a problem with it. This is where Henderson Bayou goes into Amit River, right at the failed floodgate. And it was constructed in conjunction with the excavation of Henderson Bayou or Lake Velar into Amit River years ago. And it was constructed by the parish part of that project, and the cables are breaking, and they have another problem with it, and it was repaired once, and it's breaking again, and it's something going on there that we can't determine. And we need to get an engineer involved with coming up with a suggestion.
Bill, we didn't go through legal with that as far as seeing who was liable for that. I thought that came out of the board.
Well, they looked at one time, I think somebody looked at it and said that the soil had something to do with the deterioration of the cables, and we had a geotech check it out. There's nothing wrong with the soil.
Then the last thing we heard that the cables were not the right type.
That's right.
So
it's not the right type.
I thought we were looking at legal whether that was a liability. They used the wrong cable.
But yeah, but I don't know if we can go back that far back.
Mr.
I'm not sure.
If you don't mind, we don't know if we can go back, but let's just send it to legal. Let him review it. And then let's decide next month. Let's cover all our bases before we decide to spend a bunch of money, and we may have recourse on the original contractor. Let's let Mr. O'Neill review it and give us an opinion at least.
We've done spent quite a bit of money on this particular bulkhead. This is going to be the third one. The first one failed very early, very soon. After investigating it, you come to find out that the contractor did not use spec cable holdback ties. There was a manila core, which is nothing more than a rope. So that didn't last very long at all. Then we came back and we got another contractor in to do the job. And now we're looking at this bulkhead again. That's just in history on where we're at with this particular bulkhead.
I mean, I'm not saying let's not fix it or let's not spend, but let's cover all our bases and all our avenues before we spend money. Let's just send it to Mr. O'Neill and let him review, and then we'll make a decision next month.
Make a motion.
And that is a motion.
Got a motion by Mr. Barger. I hear a second.
I'll second it.
Second. Discussion.
Yeah. Well, I mean, we've been beating this around back and forth, and there's a question about the work on it. To me, this is why URS is here. We need to send them, let them look over the specifications, review what needs to be done. I mean, we have them on board. Give them a task order to correct the specifications, make some recommendation for us. That's why they're here. And then come to us with some recommendations. Let's move forward. I don't think this is that hard to do. If that's what you're looking for, Mr. Roof.
Well, we get into the little touchy deal. If it's going to require a design that's capable of bidding out, well, then that gets into the little bit of the touchy area of the function of URS.
So this is specifications?
Well, if we're going to bid it out, and we're going to have to bid it out, so we need specifications to bid it out. And the specifications need to come from a design engineer. So that's not the little bit of a problem that we have. Now, of course, URS is going to be involved looking at the specifications coming from the other engineer.
Don't we already have specifications for it? I mean, obviously, for it to be bid out before, they had to have some.
I don't know if it was bid out before. I think they just got quotes on it. I'm not sure, and done as part of a project through quotes. I'm not exactly sure.
So this thing was built without any specifications?
And a lot of our old timber bulkheads, we have a number of them that we had local people come in there and just do a standard bulkhead design themselves. The contractor came in and just built a bulkhead. Well, that was done in the past a number of places.
Well, then,
Mr. Chairman, I'm sorry.
I just think as we go through and get a legal opinion with Mr. Varga saying that, I mean, that's something that can be done quite quickly, but we need to move forward and task somebody that has not had a problem in this parish building bulkheads, design a bulkhead specification so that we can move forward.
Well, if you're with me, I mean, I can check with Mr. Parrington. If he cannot file some kind of suit or have some legal recourse, we'll come back to the board at the next meeting with a recommendation of an engineer
I'd like to add that to if they cannot pursue legal issues, that they can come forward with a task order for some company to move forward with this. So we're going to have to wait.
Just
longer.
Make a substitute.
I'll offer that as a substitute motion that we move forward. Second. With it
a motion by second. A substitute motion on the floor by Mr. Shakesnyder, second by Mr. Barga, to send it to legal and then let DPW come back with a recommendation with a task order to a firm to give us some specs. Any more discussion? Any objections? So moved. Number 10 is chipping and shredding of Bayou Boil. Review quotes from Chemspray, Mr. Bill Roof.
Yes, sir. We had quotes received. We're going to hand out right now the response from Chemspray. This is for Boil Bayou. And I don't have one in front of me. I think it's $147,000 and some change to do, $149,000 to do 4 miles of Boil Bayou chipping. The specifications are indicated on the sheet. And this is coming, bringing it back to the board to see what's your pleasure. And it's $147,840. And this is at the request of the Drainage Board at the last meeting, I think, to look at some projects and look at some work that different companies can do.
Mr. Shakespeare.
This is in an area that has been prone to have flooding problems, and if you take a look at Ball Bayou, it's quite frankly, it's a mess. And all of the area around the hospital, the future development around Cabela's, all of that area around goes all the way up to I-10, and then in back of Southwood Subdivision and all of there that is continually having water problems. This is contributing to it. From what I understand, I think this is about $7 a foot, somewhere around there, which is comparable to anything. Talked to a couple other parishes, that's a pretty good price for cleaning and grubbing and doing all of this. So I would very much be in favor of getting that. I think it would go forward and doing this ahead of the development that's going to be coming, that's going to be causing
more water to go through that area. So I think we'd be very proactive in getting this done in a timely manner.
Mr. Sedmore?
Yeah, I see it here. The trees to be mulched to grade shall be 10 inches in diameter. What will that do us? What would that do for us in cleaning Ball Bayou? Does that mean that we're going to leave a lot of trees that may be 12 to 16 inches in diameter? I mean, willow trees will get 16-inch diameter pretty quick. I mean, what are we going to clear the bar bank or the ditch if we're going to stick with the 10-inch diameter? What's the bar bank going to look like when we finish if
you're
we don't
get
anything other above 10 inches?
You're going to get the majority of the brush, and we can go 10 inches and below. You get the majority of everything clean 10 foot on each side. You won't have everything, but you have it clean enough where you make it more efficient for float water to go through there. You won't have the brush itself. The trees don't hold back as much as the brush. Now, even the tree is going to be chipped as far up as can reach, you know, far as the limbs and things like this. So it'd just be the trunk of the tree itself left. But you'll have the vast majority of the brush cleaned.
All right. Second, what kind of time frame? Did they give you a time frame, Bill?
No, they did not. Right now, if we were to do it, it would probably be about a two-month job. And, we can't take down a 10-inch. We'd probably go 8-inch or below. But it's probably a two-month job for our machine. So we estimate it'll be less than that for them.
Can we get a representative from Kim's Play to let us know what time frames is?
I don't think anybody's here.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Back Bill, here. He's here.
We estimate the job about 30 to 45 days.
Okay. I make a motion. We go ahead and attempt to let Kim Spray do some work for us and give him this job. I think a lot of people on this council would like to see the results of something that we've contracted out, and I know that we take a burden off of some of our regular crucial areas in the parish, and I'd like to make that motion.
To second it and also ask if you would provide us with a follow-up with some pictures.
Sure.
Beforehand,
we could do before
and then also
and
after the job's complete.
No problem. We do that all the time.
Okay.
No
appreciate
problem.
That.
Todd, that would be, is this our first attempt with something like this, Bill? Mm-hmm. I would think it would be pending legal that O'Neill, if you hadn't had O'Neill kind of look this over, I'm sure there would be some kind of contract we'd probably need with them to establish this and do this job.
It's a question I have. Is this the type of thing we'd have to bid out?
Well, you're saying that's the issue that we have to talk to Mr. Parenton about. Anything over $100,000, we're supposed to bid out. This comes in at $147,000. Now, under $100,000, you can get quotes on.
And that's why I said pending legal.
Right. Now, we may have to lessen the scope of the project to fit under the $100,000. And this is something else we'll work it out with legal.
Right. Mr. Parenton stepped out, but maybe he's coming back in. He can tell us that. Mr. O'Neill. Okay,
you still got the floor, George. Go ahead.
Mr. O'Neill, we're discussing this this quote here on this 147. It is over $100,000. This would be something primarily the drainage board would have to bid out with specifications?
I think so.
Okay. It's not a service that it's not a service type that we could.
It seems like a major project. We're
going to ask you to do some research on that. And I'm going to leave my motion as it is, just in case that it is possible, pending legal definition. Well, you can't do it in phases either.
How about this?
Can't do that in phases.
The only thing we can
do is allow him to do up to $100,000 work.
I'm not sure we can do that either. No. We've already stated what we're doing here. Mm-hmm. Believe me, we can't do that. So let's just let Ms. O'Neill come back with a decision. We may be having a special drainage meeting in the next couple of weeks anyway on some other things. So as soon as you can, O'Neill, try to get that back to us. But that's my motion, pending legal. Okay.
I think most of us know who he is. Thank you, Mr. Chairman. But just for the record, could the speaker state his name and his position with Chemspray?
John DeVille, the president of Chemspray.
Thank you.
Thank you, John.
I have one question. Could you piggyback it off another contract? a parish contract?
No, sir. I don't think so. I'm not going to answer for the attorney.
No, we've already discussed that issue.
Okay. Yeah, we really can't. So public bid law, prevents us from doing that. So okay. we'll have to do a scope, have to do so much. I mean, we might be able to do 2 miles.
Sure.
But it'll have to come back as something that we'll have to bid.
We'll work with y'all any way we can.
Okay. Thank you.
And if we could in the future, let's be aware that we just put this man in a very unfair position as far as presenting his price to the board, and we didn't ask anybody else to bid on it. Now everybody knows his price. So let's try to remember, if it may be over $100,000, we may need to get a few quotes. Just something, food for thought.
I just, all fairness to the board, I mean, I actually thought this was a bid, and he was low bid, to be very honest with you. I didn't realize we were just doing this for an example.
I can explain. I mean, at the last meeting, you had the representative of Chemspray come by and make a request to look at some work, and the board asked us to review some projects and see what they can do. We gave them that, and they came back with this quote. And right now, again, what we're asking to do is review the quotes of Chemspray, and to look at the fact that we're looking at some fairly large numbers here, and we may need to go to another process. We just can't just say, let Chemspray have a couple of projects, because they are costly projects, and they're over the $100,000. So we need to look at this whole thing that you're requesting us to do.
Right. I think, Mr. Rue, in all fairness, this board had suggested, and I think the comment was made that there wasn't a whole lot of people out there that would do this. And we had talked about somebody local doing it, and we certainly appreciate Chemspray. I know they do a lot of fine work around the parish and across the state. But that's the reason why we ended up in this situation. So let's stay legal with everything.
Mr. President. John, one question. Isn't this the wrong time of the year to really do herbicide spraying?
Well, this would be for spraying the stumps, all the trees that we grind to keep them from coming back out.
All right, so the spring would be the right time of the year for it'd be the right time growth is fixing to take
but
off.
But if you stump treating, you could do it immediately after you cut everything.
Thank you, sir.
More discussion? We got a motion by Mr. Ballantyne, second by Mrs. Fontenot, to move forward on this pending legal and come back with us at the next meeting with it, I guess.
No.
Any objection? So moved.
Mr. Lambert.
Valentine.
I'd like to also challenge Mr. Rue, if he would, and when as soon as he gets a ruling from Mr. Parrington, that he get some specs drawn up that would that we could put out to bid. Indeed, that probably will be the result of this discussion. So,
yeah. We'll move on to number 11, CVS Pharmacy Servitude Agreement. Mr. Bill Rue.
Yes, sir. We talked about it several months ago. I just talked about the idea of doing some work in a large ditch on where CVS is building a new pharmacy, corner of Highway 61 and 42 in Prairieville. And there's a large ditch going behind the proposed site. They offered, court through because of liability issue, had some flooding at the church. They got large covers coming diagonally across from LA 42 from Broussard Church. And they were concerned about liability issues if they would fill that ditch in with covers. We would like it filled in. It would relieve us of future maintenance problems all along that area. They offered to pay all costs, our labor costs, equipment costs, fuel costs.
So moved.
And I reviewed that contract.
Right.
Any discussion? Any objection?
Mr. Parrington said he reviewed it and it's okay. So.
Yeah.
So moved. Number 12 is a culvert replacement in Bayou Nassis at LA 74 roadway crossing. Authorization to spend $62,117 for upgrading of crossing. Mr. Bill Rue.
Yes, sir. This is the Bayou Nassis coming under Highway 74 up behind the railroad tracks. We've been having problems there. It's beginning to be a bottleneck, and DOTD will be upgrading Highway 74. And when they do so, we're requesting that those covers be replaced and upgraded to a larger. And it can cost. We're responsible to pay the bill for the covers, but which is some large aluminum box covers. But DOTD will install. So
They're asking us to pay $62,117.26 for the cost of the material, and it would be a benefit to our drainage of Baino season.
Motion. So moved. That's a good thing.
Motion by Mr. Hillensbeck, second by Mr. Shakespeare. Discussion? Any objections? So moved. Number 13, contract with URS. Bill Ruth.
Yes, sir. This was taken to the council, but it was not taken to the drainage board. This is the annual renewal of the task order contract with URS as our consultant engineers. Some parts of it has been changed a little bit to reflect task orders. The same as with the council. What we're requesting is that the total limit is $100,000 for a drainage-related task, and it will be tasked by the drainage board. There's only one other little change, is that the task order is submitted by the designee of the East Ascension Gravity Drains District Board. And as of right now, we would like two resolutions, one to accept the contract, and the other one is to appoint the or select the Department of Public Works Director as our designee.
I so move, Mr. Chairman.
Second.
Got a motion by Mr. McConnell, second by Mr. Savoy. Any discussion, Mr.
Yes. Bill, in the past, we've had these task orders, and U.S. was involved in. Then we assigned them some investigative material to do on some of our lawsuits mm-hmm. that we've had, and it had caused the cost to go up, and it has nothing to do with the initial assignment that we've given them. So I'd like to take the contract that we have and exempt that ceiling to not include any of the lawsuit money that we would task them to do, because that's something that's totally separate and would not be involved in any of the drainage information that we had. I don't know what's going to happen down the road, but we may get into a lawsuit situation where we task them to do some investigation there, and that may bring their overall cost over that, which has nothing to do with the normal assignment. So I would like to
as part of the contract, we added one little section to perform, and I think it's Article 1, to perform tasks. The types of services to be provided under this agreement will include those dictated by individual task orders submitted by the designee of the Ascension Parish Gravity District, but shall generally include those services listed in Attachment 1 of this contract. So you look at all the way at the end of the contract, there is a list of activities that is normally accepted as part of their contract, and I don't think legal review or legal looking at working for the district attorney on legal issues is part of that list, so that would be separate.
That would be something we'd have to...
Right. That was something we would bring separately to the board. So we'll refer to this list as this is a commonly accepted task that we're able
to... So moved.
...to give to them.
Got a motion and a second already. Any more discussion? Any objection? So moved. Number 14, Lego Wetland Mitigation Contract, Dredging Operation Mitigation. Mr. Bill Ruth.
Yeah, this is a continuation of clearing up some wetland mitigation. This is actually, if you remember back, we had a wetland mitigation contract with Lago Espinoza on the New River section of the initial project, which is the first stages of the original dredging project years ago. This is mitigation of the just completed sections of Bay North Seas and Black Bayou up to where they stopped at U.S. 61 and Black Bayou Road. And the cost of the mitigation just for Cypress, I think, 35.5 acres of Cypress Swamp, price is $145,025, and requesting acceptance.
Motion, Mr. Chairman.
Motion by Mr. Savoy.
Second.
Second by Mr. Berger. Discussion?
We've got...
Mr. Savoy.
It's in the budget. We got some monies in the mm-hmm. budget for that anyway.
Yes, sir.
Any more discussion? Any objections? So moved. Move on to number 15, agreement between the East Ascension Drainage and New River Soil and Water Conservation District.
So moved, Mr. Chairman.
It's a yearly...
Motion by Mr. Savoy, second by Mrs. Fontenot. Discussion? Any objection? So moved. Move on to number 16, railroad flagman, authorization to pay up to $7,300.
Correction on that, it's up to $7,800.
$7,800.
So moved.
So moved by Mr. Shakespeare. Second by Mrs. Fontenot. Discussion.
I want to let you know that I did meet with the railroad representatives last week at the state capitol, and they simply contract this service out, and state law mandates that anything that happens within the railroad right-of-way, a flagman has to be provided. And so their hands are tied, our hands are tied, and they're just passing on the cost of us. That was one of the things we discussed and tried to get the cost down, and we just simply could not do it. And so it's something that's necessary, and I'd like to move on.
Any more discussion? Any objections? So moved. Move on to number 17, Fife Subdivision. Mr. Adrian Thompson, he is not here. Bill, we have anything?
I can give a brief report. I think Mr. McConnell might have some interest in it. The we had a plan to dig a ditch along property adjacent to Fife Subdivision. That's phase one, and we have phase two, improvement of ditches within Fife Subdivision. Phase three is possible pumping situation, levee and pump. But the first phase is the primary project that we wanted to do is the ditch along the adjacent property, trying to get right-of-way, and we failed to get the right-of-way. We're still talking to them, but it looks like they're pretty adamant and not giving us the right-of-way in that area. So now we're going to another design plan, possibly two a combination of two and three, phase two and three, and see how we combine it and make it work. Okay. That's where we are on it.
Thank you, Bill. Move on to number 18, bulkheads at West Irmer.
I'll take that one.
Mr. McConnell?
That's actually in my district. Mr. Okay. Thompson introduced that. But some months ago I had given some information. There's along Bayou Francois near the ballpark.
Right.
There's a considerable amount of erosion going on because of the location, it has to be sprayed to maintain the Bayou Francois, and there's some erosion going on, and so I'd given Mr. Roof some specs some months ago to look at the possibility. It's been the drainage board's policy that whenever there's some erosion in the bayou that's existing, that as long as the property owner, in this case it would be City of Gonzales, pays the cost of the materials, and the parish would come in and share that cost by providing the labor. And I'm just wondering if Mr. Rue, he got the specs a while back. You got a price yet, Bill?
No, we're actually talking to GSA. GSA is the city's engineer, and they are coming back to us, and we'll bring it back to the board at the next meeting, looking at the difference in putting a timber bulkhead, a standard timber bulkhead there, or going with a steel bulkhead. He's also going to talk to the mayor and seeing about the cost share, how much if it is going with a steel bulkhead, how much the city will put up for materials. And we're going to bring all this information back to the board at the next meeting.
All right. And by the way, it was a concern of mine when we started talking about that, because I still hold out hope that one day in the future we're going to continue the dredging up Bayou Francois, and that we can work out all of those difficulties that we've had, and this is part of that section. So I was reluctant to put in a bulkhead if we were going to dredge Bayou Francois and have to come in and take it in, but Mr. Rue and other people I've talked to assures me that there's room on the other side, so this is not a bulkhead that we would have to mess with for future branch. So the board doesn't have to worry about putting it in and then digging it up a few years later.
Martin, while we're talking about this, it's on the same area, just a little bit down. I visited Papara Lumber Yard this morning. They called me and Mr. Allen Allred went and looked at it. They got some buildings that's falling into the canal. So, Bill, if we can address that as far as looking at a feasibility on the bulkhead situation there. Martin, if you want to agree with that.
Again, all of that was originally in the drainage plan when we were going to we stopped at Highway 61 and we were going to continue forward. I think I heard that mentioned once or twice at a drainage board in the past, but when we stopped that and changed that kind of negated the whole thing. But that was the problem, is those buildings are right there. The bayou has eroded to the edge of the buildings, and so it was going to have to be protected or bulkheaded right there to protect those buildings to continue that whole dredging thing. So That's where we are. And this board voted not to do that because you didn't want to pay that price for those bulkheads. Now, I agree that they need to be done, and I'd like to look at it further.
I think Alan has a temporary fix on some of the areas he can get to with some riprap, so he's got that on the books to go ahead and get that done. They're in a double curve right there.
Yes, they are.
Yes, sir. My comment on by the ballparks, we may mention that the maintenance of spraying is the cause of the bulkhead. Well, if all we're doing is spraying by the ballparks, please let's investigate doing riprap there instead of spending the money on bulkheads to see if that is a comparable fix. If all we're doing is spraying behind ballparks, let's look at riprap instead of bulkheads.
Thank you. More questions on that?
Mr. Rue, Byron Henderson, Francois, in that one of the canals at the State Public Works designated in 1984, I believe, and then the East Ascension Drainage Board designated that we have a 100-foot right-of-way on either side, and buildings should not be built within that right-of-way?
Yes, sir.
Have any of those buildings, say, on this property that was just mentioned been built since 84?
No, they were all prior.
I know of at least one that's been at.
These particular buildings were probably built before 84. These were some of the oldest buildings that...
If I may, this is the old part of the lumber yard, been there a long, long time.
Thank you.
Okay. Move on to number 19, update on Panama Canal and Bayou Conway cleaning. Mr. Shakespeare.
I think Mr. Rue has already answered that. To review it, is the 28th is bids will be?
The bids were sent out on the 28th, October 28th, and they're due back in November 28th. And it should be the first of the year, probably, for mobilization if the bids come in within budget, I would think.
Okay. Can you keep us informed on that? And
we will.
And we'll keep that on the next agenda.
Move on to number 20, which is a 2007 budget. Jerry Savoy.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. I put it on there for our discussion because we did say that we wanted to pass the major drainage budget as the drainage board to the full council. Reviewing the budget, I've got a couple of items that I'd like to bring to your attention. If you look back on the capital projects recap, and Bill, you can help me here, because two of them, you identified two of them. One is bank erosion. You do have that, and the total bill is, for the East Central major construction, we're talking about spending $15 million. How much do you plan on dedicating to bank erosion? Because if you look back on tab, get back to the 05 budget, you do have a line item, erosion control, at a cost of $6,700. So tell me the difference between this line item versus the construction. I mean, how much you...
This we have two. We have maintenance, which is in the maintenance budget. This is construction. This is really out of the ordinary type. Like we're talking about, say, along the park, where we have to put riprap in those areas, like we did along by North Seas, south of east of 61. Those type of issues for construction, we hire somebody to come in, or we have to purchase special riprap material to do it. And we're estimating, again, this is just budgeted items, just to put something in so we can, if something would come up, we have the money to do it with. Bank erosion is, we budgeted $50,000 to do that type of riprap. Bank erosion, or some type of plantings of certain type of grasses or something like this. The only thing we budget is $50,000 right now.
The reason why, let me remind us that we spent $20,000 evaluating erosion problems that we had throughout the parish. And one of the things that came out of the $20,000 study was that we should look at doing some erosion control upstream and downstream of all of our bridges that has had dredging projects done. I'm going to ask that we allocate some monies to start doing that. I'm not looking at doing them all in one year, but that is something I think we would need to try to move towards so we can at least get some of our $20,000 worth. Now, do I have a couple of them in mind? Yes, I do. I got a couple of problem areas. It's been a problem area for quite some time. Y'all have heard me talk about it, and that's the one off of 22 and the one off of Roger C. Road Bridge. That's two areas that there is erosion problem, and according to the evaluation, it's caused by the boating traffic along that river where they got to stop in the bigger wake and then they take off. So so far as what it costs to try to take care of that, I don't know if $50,000 enough, you know. But I would like for us to actively look toward addressing those two areas.
Mr. Shakespeare.
I agree with Mr. Savoy from the standpoint of not just those two areas, but Bill, if you take a look at all the areas that we need and what it would take maybe in a 2 or 3 year period to spread things out. Mm-hmm. I think that's something we really need to be proactive and address before we have problems. And just in the past, we just really we've done it on a piecemeal basis. And I think if you get a program in where you guys can go ahead and set it in the budget and and get started proactively, I think we would be better served.
I think I can from the outset, let's clear up a few things, I guess, right now. And that is the fact that by law, we're required to present a budget by a certain date, have it adopted by a certain date. So we were under the gun several months ago to prepare a budget. What we're, DPW, is looking at doing, and whatever way that the board decides to go for us, what's going to happen the first of the year. Fact of the matter is the DPW or whomever will have to come back to the board. We're looking at doing it right now. We're preparing detailed plans for a 5-year construction projects, detailed out in much more detail than what we have here. And what we're looking at doing is actually coming back to the board with a multi-year plan with specific projects, with specific numbers on it, with the input of the board on what these projects should be, have the board adopt that, and then we move forward with a comprehensive plan. At that point in time, we'll actually look at naming certain projects, putting numbers on it, and putting dates and priorities on it. So this is a budget that you need to accept or authorize, but let you know that we are coming back with a much more definitive budget and project list end of this year, before the end of the year. So I know we got a lot of things. Most of the stuff you look at this is mostly carryover stuff, project that's happening already, that's in progress, but we are going to come back with a more comprehensive list of projects.
Just allow a certain amount of money for the erosion control, that's all, and we'd like to see that amount go up a little bit because we're kind of behind in that, and whatever you think is justified for that, just let us know.
We have two different, one of the things that changed the scenario a little bit is the fact, we have some points at some of these bridges what we need to do with erosion control on each side. We were talking about it and doing an evaluation of Bayou Francois and Black Bayou, the full route, the full distance of both those bayous and doing some kind of control. But with the determination of the Corps of Engineers for Natural Bank, allowing most of this to go back to Natural Bank, which in itself provides erosion control, we're rethinking what we can do. Instead of going through there and planning, we will be going through there and planting trees and probably let most of this bank line go back to natural vegetation. Well, that in itself will provide the erosion control. So we're rethinking the whole scenario of what we're going to do along both all these major bayous mandated by the Corps of Engineers.
The next thing is going to be the mandate by the Corps and replanting of trees. That was another issue. I see you've got down here U.S. Corps of Engineer permitting. All right. Do you have any monies allocated to a replanting program to where we can start, to where we can show the Corps that we are actively moving toward settling some of these issues?
We don't have it in this. Again, we're going to be coming back with comprehensive list. However, this started before all of these issues came up. And we don't have any idea. We have no earthly idea what it's going to cost because we're still negotiating with Corps on the distance, how much planning we will do, and the full extent of planning. So this is an ongoing negotiation that we have no idea what the cost will be, and we won't have that until we get the plan put together on the planning and submit that to some consultants or to some contractors to get a price back. It's a multi-year plan.
Okay.
on planting. And it's something we've never been involved with.
And you say you've been working on this for quite a while?
What's that?
As far as the replanting and the erosion?
No, the replanting, that came out of the probably the last few months because of talking to the Corps of Engineers. In the fact that we weren't in compliance with the prior permitting of the 1990s. And that's where that came up about as far as the replanting and the whole situation of allowing this to go back to natural vegetation. This just evolved over the last few months. So it changes everything. And we just don't have the information right now to be able to put numbers on it.
Now, one other thing is grass and lilies. We do have a problem. Y'all brought it up earlier this year. Talked about spraying, talked about it settling to the bottom, and you got to deal with it. But let me tell you something. You better deal with it before it gets to the pump. If you've never seen the pump operate and what has to happen for those pumps to operate efficiently, I do not believe that we can allow the bayous to plug up the way we have this year. And at the right situation, the right scenario, all that grass and all those debris and lilies end up at the pumping station. Don't expect our manpower to keep up. Don't expect our equipment to keep up. Now, I think it would be prudent on our part to get with LSU, the Cooperative Extension, or get with somebody to see what types of grasses there's out there, see if there's anything that we can do to try to scale back the growth that's happening here, because we're in a serious problem here. Now, I've been watching this grass and this lily grow more and more over the course of the last 3 years, and what I've seen this year, whenever you got it crossing all the way to Bayou Francois and Blank Bayou, we got a problem. So that's just food for thought. I'm looking for somebody to come back to us that's got some knowledge on vegetation and some means to get it under control.
Yeah, Councilman, I want to comment on that because we started looking at it pretty closely for us, the lilies and the type of vegetation floating on top of the water right now just over the last few months. And now they're starting to die out now, the high water starting to take some of them out. The fact of the matter is we're really concerned, once we look at it, of the difference in having floating debris go to the pumping station, i.e. the lilies and everything else while they're still alive, or as they die, float down and come underwater to the pumping station. If they have to get to the pumping station, we want them on top of the water because we got 4-foot forks on our retaining basin outside restricting anything 4 foot down from coming into our suction. So if we kind of, you know, looking at the fact, what if we kill it and it comes, dies down, and it floats under this 4-foot area and gets into our pumping system that way. So we're real cautious on how we're proceeding with this. We are going to be putting together a plan to come in the spring and do some type of vegetation control. But we're trying to talk to as many people as possible to what would happen if, in fact, it do die, and what would happen if they float underwater to our pumping station, whereas instead of on top of the water. So we're looking at that. We're looking at everything to start some kind of program in the spring. But we let you know we are evaluating and looking at it.
Okay, so you're looking at that in the spring. Mm-hmm. You're looking at the planning program. When do you anticipate that to come back to you?
The planning.
Replanting.
Oh, well, right now, we're talking to the Corps on trying to negotiate with the Corps in reality. They have a planting scheme now so many feet between certain types of trees. And now we're trying to get that stretched further apart to give us a little bit of break on how much trees to put in. The other issue is the fact of how far we have to plant. They're saying 15 foot away from, we can maintain the bank 15 foot away. After that, we need to go back to natural vegetation with certain types of trees. What we're looking at now is not doing that. If we can do anything, we'll just move everything over to the bank, plant next to the bank too, and have natural vegetation along the bank with a canopy, and we'll have the same effect. We have erosion control, where we don't have to maintain that bank, and it's better for the wildlife. So we are looking at the core. Instead of, we have so many feet from the side over, just moving it over 15 and put everything along the bank line, let everything go back to natural vegetation, but planted vegetation, selected types of trees. So, again, this is it's all up in the air right now. We're doing our best to do the right thing and the most efficient and cost-effective project for the parish. And it's going to take us a little bit more time to determine exactly what we're going to do.
So we're not planning on spending no money in 07?
Oh, we are going to spend some money in 07. Well, let me back up. We may not, because the planting season is, as determined by the Corps of Engineers, from January to March. Now, I don't think we can hit that window of opportunity, you know, this coming year. But now, we'll probably get our plan together. I don't look at spending that much money except for consultants or a plan, which is minimal amount of money, to determine what we're going to do. And then it'll probably go in effect January of 08. Because, again, the planting season is from January to March. That's when they want the trees planted, the plan going. So it's going to be a multi-year plan, doing it just those 3 or 4 months. Maybe you might better stretch it out to April. But you're only looking at 3 or 4 months a year. So to answer your question, I doubt we're going to spend that much money on planting this coming year, just for the plan itself. So.
That's all I got.
Mr. Shakespeare.
Well, I just want to emphasize, I agree with Mr. Savoy on the idea of the lilies, and at a certain point from the pumps, and what we're talking about is not coming back and waiting for the lilies to grow across the canal and then kill them. What we're looking for is a program to control them, and that as the outbreak comes early in the spring, that we have a program, and if this is something that we don't have the expertise to do, we need to look out for someone that does have the expertise to come in with the program to kill and maintain this vegetation so far from the pumps so that we do not have either lilies above the water or below the water. We should not have either one. And I think that's very important. I think that's something that we've seen when we had to draw down the pumps this year in Sorrento. And I think we've seen it. It's pretty obvious on the other one. So I would definitely like to see investigate and have an ongoing program of maintenance that's going to prevent us from getting to the situation where we have these lilies that are taking over like they are doing now. And that is done in other places also.
And just to comment on that, we are going to be coming back to you probably no later than February meeting. With this, with the plan and the cost for authorization by the board to go further with it, we're going to be working on it between now and then.
Yeah, Bill, would you send me a breakout of the capital outlay projects? The 2007 is in the budget. Those items itemized under the $6,870,000.
Yes, sir.
Would you send me that? It's like it's all grouped together. It's kind of hard to figure out what's. Where
right.
The money's going.
No, I have it all for us. When I put the budget together, I itemize it out, and then it's collectively put in for the budget.
Yeah, I just need that section only. Mm-hmm. Thank you.
What's the wishes of the board on the budget? Y'all want to move on it tonight?
Can we hold off one more? Do we have time to hold off one more meeting?
Be moved on. Ms. Gwen?
If you're referring to your December meeting, that would be too late. You have to adopt the budget by state law and our home rule charter 30 days prior to the end of the year. So that's December 2nd, officially.
Mr. Bargas.
Yeah, thank you, Mr. Chair. Where does the separation of the drainage board, does that matter, or you still have to send it through?
Well, that's in accordance with the Local Budget Act. I mean, that applies to all local governments in Louisiana.
Including the committee. Okay, good enough.
In special districts.
A motion by Mr. Byrd.
Second
by Mr. Valentine to approve the presented budget. Discussion, Mr.
Well, Byrd. No, and the council, I mean, the drainage board surely knows we can come back and adjust the budget and anything right. We want. So that we stay legal and within the law, we need to approve it tonight, as is. Yeah. We appreciate all the input Mr. Savo has, but we need to approve it.
Any more discussion?
I just got a couple of questions. Make sure I understand some of the things that Bill answered. Most of our buyers are water bill. Does the state have any responsibility with vegetation control on with these hyacinths and other forms of growing? Doesn't wildlife and fisheries have a responsibility to?
At one time, I think DOTD were assisting in that type of control. Also, wildlife and fisheries did help us in some sometimes in the past on certain types of weed control in some of these bayous also. So to say if they have they're able to do it if they want to, if they have it in our budget to do it, but both wildlife and fisheries and DOTD have said they do not have it in the budget, so they're declining to get involved because it's not budgeted.
Well, Neil, do you know if there's any legal opinions on that? State bodies of water. Would you check that, please,
sure,
for the administration? Thank you. Now, did I understand you correctly on the revegetation that this was supposed to have been done back when they originally dredged these canals and building McElroy Pumping Station and others?
They did not have a time. It's part of the original permit, and it was, but it did not have a time limit per se on it. They did say that part of the permit process, you shall have a revegetation plan, and you should vegetate that in accordance to certain criteria and specification that the Corps put in the permit.
So you're going back to 1990.
Mm-hmm.
Well, no, and obviously back then there wasn't a parish president administering the drainage board. There was an administrator that the drainage board had hired. So obviously somebody neglected to put that plan together between 1990 and 94. Is that correct?
Actually, you're looking more at in the middle 90s. Late 90s to now.
But the 1990 permit had a requirement that revegetation be done, so
right.
We're not supposed to leave any of these bayous clear where we can go in and maintain them and
most
cut them?
Most of it is on one side, is completely back to natural vegetation. On the other side, it's you plant a certain type of species 15 foot away. You're allowed to have 15 foot along the bayou to maintain that if you wish. And start planting thereafter. And again, what we're looking at doing is not doing that. It's going all the way to the bank by because of erosion and wildlife. But that's specifications of the permit.
How does that play into the major channels that were designated by the state and by the drainage board in 84? And we have 100-foot maintenance right away on each of the high banks. I mean, it seems like to me, what kind of trees are they? We're not going to be able to maintain and cut along these channels.
They don't want us to. They want to let it go back to natural vegetation with specific species of trees planted along there. Mostly your bottom, your hardwoods,
like that would,
and
would,
some cypress.
Would hurt our drainage maintenance needs going forward. We're going to cost us more money to knock that down if we got to go in there and widen the channel or something. Has this been addressed with the Corps from a legal point of view, O'Neill? You,
yes. Well,
the Corps is, they give you their legal,
yeah,
requirements of what you have to do. It's part of their process, and you have to get permits from them.
And once you, it's a sign of the contract. Once you accept the permit, you sign the permit, agreeing to do these items in the permit. So it's
all right,
a
so all the work
thereafter.
We're doing right now in Black Bob, if I understand you correctly, we're supposed to go replant trees all along there?
Exactly.
That we just knocked down?
That's right. And go back, put it back to the way it was, or actually put it back better than the way it was, and leave it alone. And the other side of the coin is this. I mean, the bayou should be, these particular canals, channel, should have been improved to the point where we don't have to go back in there for a lot of years. We're talking about 50 plus years or more, if ever. So that's the decision, is to go back and put it back to natural vegetation.
I disagree, I think, though, Mr. Rue, on this point, because with our storms and hurricanes and all, we're having to go in and clean out trees that are knocked down and over the year. I just really think we need to try to address this, O'Neill, legally with the Corps. I mean, just take Katrina and Rita last year, the number of trees that are down within the right-of-way and in the canal itself. Plus, now we're planting trees so a hurricane can blow them in the canal to restrict the drainage with a future storm. You know, it's like if something just doesn't make sense there with common sense with the taxpayers' money. Now, maybe it's the type of, they're going to be little small specimens of trees and it won't be a problem, but I could see that being a huge problem.
Mm-hmm.
No matter if it's 50 years or 20 years, it's going to inhibit drainage instead of, I want to have things nice and, you know, environmentally good, but I'm not so sure. This is something we don't really need to try to sit down with the Corps with and
We have talked at length with them, believe me, because we really don't want to go through that, but it's an issue that they will not relent. They're definite. This is one thing that has to be done.
And from the legal standpoint, the legal issue, the legal position of the Corps and all these matters is if you do it the way we tell you, we don't give you a permit. You're not entitled to a permit.
Mr. Lane.
Okay, thank you.
Mr. Hillenbeck had a question for you.
Yeah, Bill, back to the $6,870,000. Is any of that money designated toward construction of this this levee to Summerfield?
The levee to Summerfield?
Yeah. You know, the levee from the end of Prince Road?
No.
By whatever the best route is to Summerfield?
The only thing is some design and engineering costs on both the Law Ridge levee and the Henderson Bayou Basin is mostly design or engineering monies for that. No construction because we not anywhere close to getting to that. We look at 1 year at a time in this budget, and we're not going to be getting anywhere near that this coming year.
Any more discussion?
I just have one comment, and Mr. Rue, I'm sure you know, but URS, I think they got some people on staff, and we have a task order with them, specialty where they deal with the Corps of Engineers. That might just be a suggestion.
We have been Jim LeBlanc has been working with CJ and the Corps, I guess, every week since this
That's
issue
fine,
came
Bill.
Out. He's our primary contact with the Corps.
I just want to make sure the public understands that we do have URS task on that situation.
URS is our primary source.
You can
source.
Vote on the budget now.
Ms. Fondo has one question.
I just wanted to comment on the tree issue and the growth around the bayous and stuff and dealing with Revive New River. Some of the stuff that had come out is the fish are dying. The summers are really hot. The water gets real low, and they don't have the proper cover and the proper shade, nor the proper nutrition. Because if you have the bigger, taller plants that the dragonflies and things like that land on it, that's what the fish, you know, eat. So it's about the ecology.
Okay, we got a motion by Mr. Barger, second by Mr. Valentine. We'll go ahead with the budget. Any objections? So moved. Chairman's report. I got someone had signed in. I didn't say Kevin Roach. Is Mr. Kevin, he had to leave? Okay. One other thing on my report is Mr. Mike Paterno have given each of y'all in front of y'all some comments on the proposed Ascension drainage ordinance, and if any of y'all have any questions for him, he'd be glad to come up and answer. He'll be in front of y'all.
I was just going to state that y'all had asked us to just go ahead and review the ordinance, and what we've done is put together a couple of pages of comments. I'd invite everybody just to go ahead and look at that, review it, and let us know if you've got any questions. We'd be happy to work with you on those things.
Thank you, Mr. Mike. Any questions now for us? Okay. That's it on my report. We'll move on to number 22, executive session for Z Delta. We got a motion by Mr. Byard.
Second.
Second by Mrs. Fontenot. Any discussion? Any objection?
Second.
Got a motion to reconvene by Mr. Barger, second by Mrs. Fontenot.
Motion to adjourn, Mr. Chairman.
Any objections? All we got was just an update on the Z Delta. Just an update. Nothing moved on. Adjourned by Mr. Barger. Second by Mr. Savoy. He never objected. So moved. I'll see you tomorrow.